Our students, now actually we have a look at the format of data structures. So the main data structures or databases are required for the both the passes that pass 1 and pass 2 are the first one is machine or table. Okay, and this is required for both pass 1 and pass 2, and next is pseudo of table. So the same thing, so this is for pass 1 and pass 2, and next one is symbol table. Okay, so this is also required for pass 1 and pass 2. And base table. Okay, so now this is base table. Now we will see, we'll study one by one. Okay, now this is machine of table. So this table requires the 6 bytes per entry. The first column will tell mnemonic of codes, second column binary of code, third column instruction length, fourth column instruction format, and this is not given. Okay, so now let us have a look what is instruction format. If this is a binary code, okay, this is in the form of binary number. If 0001 means here already given, 001 means what? This is RX format, and 000 means RR format, and 100 means SS format. So like this, based on this code, the computer will understand what type of instruction format it is. Okay, now, and the assembler will also understand the length of the instruction. So based on the instruction length, okay, if 10 means the 2 half words, 4 bytes, 11 means 6 bytes, if 01 means 2 bytes. Okay, so that is, see, if it is 01, its equivalent decimal number is 1, so 10 equivalent decimal number is 2, and 11 is the equivalent decimal number is 3. So means so that is 2 bytes required. So 1 half word means 2 bytes, 2 half word means 4 bytes, 3 half word means 6 bytes. Okay, so like this, you have to explain about the machine of table. So now let us see the pseudo of table. Okay, now this is nothing but a pseudo of table. Here two columns are there. This pseudo of table requires 8 bytes per entry. Okay, so pseudo of table, first we will mention these are the pseudos: drop and EQ start using. These are some examples of pseudo of table. And to call these pseudo forms, these are nothing but, this is like calling the subroutines or functions in C and C++ language. This is same as that type of it. Okay, now this is P1 drop and P1 end, P1 EQ, P1 star, P1 using. These are nothing but the labels. So these labels are used as the pointers to these subroutines. Okay, so this is nothing but about the pseudo of table. So this address of the routine to the pseudo ops requires 3 bytes. Okay, this we have to mention. 3 bytes means 24 bit address. Okay, so 24 bits address or 3 bytes of address is required for the pseudo op. Okay, and then 5 bytes is required to store the pseudos. Okay, so means 5 bytes, the maximum number of word characters we are using in pseudo op is 5. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is 5 characters are there. Each character requires 1 byte. Okay, so that's why 5 bytes is required to store the pseudo op. Okay, so next we'll see the symbol table. So symbol table, why we use? So wherever in the program we have seen the John 4 5 jump, their symbols were there in the program. Okay, those symbols are stored. After that, the value is assigned to those symbols. Okay, so now, so these values are assigned to those symbols. Okay, then after that, the length of that symbol will be stored. And after that, the relocation, whether that symbol value is of the relocation value or absolute value. So that is specified by this column, relocation. If the character is R, means the value assigned to this symbols are relocation address. If the character A is there, means the value assigned to this symbol is absolute address. Okay, so this symbol table total, it requires 14 bytes per entry. Okay, that's it about the format of the data structures. Okay, if any doubts, put it in the comment box. And don't forget to like. Okay, so like, and any doubts, comment in the comment box. Thank you. Take care. Bye bye.